the wife of a rather unscrupulous businessman, and Johnny's a journalist, and clearly there's some sort of relationship developing between you and him throughout the movie. Yeah,
yeah, I started
this amazing career.
Hi
there, Nancy DeLolio is in the building. She'll be right here very soon. First of all, though, Ross King has been given the keys to two of Hollywood's most incredible homes. Oh, we thought we'd never come back then. We're in the kitchen, as you can see. Nancy DeLolio will be joining us shortly. Brace yourself for that, because she is going to be coming into the kitchen.
Good, good.
And James Tanner is here.
Which I'm going to show you how to make now. And also these, look, toffee apples.
Oh,
this
lovely.
This is actually my mum's old recipe
oh,
that we had.
Oh, lovely.
When the four boys were together, munching on toffee apples.
Yeah, and eating endlessly.
Indeed, but all of that's on the website. So shall we talk bread?
I think we should talk bread.
OK, so bonfire bread. I'll be honest, I've made it up. It's a trendy version of a sausage, a kind of hot dog, really, but something you can take with you to the event.
Right, OK.
It's a meal in one.
It's a portable meal for
bonfire. A portable meal. So let's talk about the ingredients. First of all, we...
It looks really simple.
It this is where it gets more difficult, OK? So you dissolve the yeast. Now, some recipes with the instant dry yeast that we use today say put it in your flour. Personally, I think by putting it in the liquid, it works in the flour better and you get a better proof. I'll explain about
proofs in a
second.
So you put the flour in the liquid rather than the other way around?
No, I put
the... Oh,
like
I can see. That's why you've made a well in the flour.
Made a well in the centre. OK, so you add your liquid all at once because, obviously, you know, different temperatures and moisture and all that stuff. OK, and to that, we add a glug of olive oil.
Ooh, nice.
This adds soft milk in it, but I really...
Would that make it like a
focaccia
type?
It does, it does. There you go, check you out.
Ooh.
Pinch of sea salt, not too much dough, but I have one done.
And then Nancy wouldn't be on because you'd have used up her 5 minutes.
I'd have used up that air time, yeah. Right, now this is some of the mixed stuff. I'm just going to put a bit of flour down. Okay? Just to give you an idea.
Oh, well done, I've got my rings. Oh, you've got rings on as well.
I'm going to get a flour down. And you just have to keep working it. And the idea is, it works. So if you do that...
Okay, but and you don't. But isn't there a thing that you don't overwork as well? Because what does that do?
For the first one, initially, you'd stretch it too much and it would spring back on you. But for the first one, this is what you need to do. You need to do exactly what you're doing there.
And you're sort of getting air out of it.
You're getting the air out of it, but all you do is afterwards, after that's done, which you've got, which is great there, you put that into a bowl, a touch of cling film over it or a tea towel, leave it for 40 minutes, it looks like that. It's proved up.
Oh, wow.
Now,
look at
this stage, at this stage...
Looks like a souffle, or doesn't that?
No, but this is what you want. At this
stage,
we're just going to roll it out. Now, get it on a baking tray. Baking tray's fine, a flat one. We've got a little... into the bread to add some little dips.
Focaccia shanks.
OK, literally, they've seen the pan literally for a couple of minutes.
Yeah.
We add these onto the bread. Can you...
Loads of cheese.
Lovely, sweet. Not too much, though. That's fine, because it'll burn. Touch of onion marmalade. On with a little bit of rosemary, just for a bit more flavour, really.
Lovely.
Now, again, tea towel over the top, OK, at this stage, very important, 40 minutes.
Right.
It proves back up again.
OK.
OK? And then it looks like this. This is the proof one. Oh, there's the proof one.
OK.
Lovely, puffed up, really, really nice.
Sausages all embedded
Indeed.
There.
Indeed. Into the oven, 200 degrees, 30 to 40 minutes until golden brown. Mm-hmm. And then you literally pull it out, you can cut this up, ready for your bonfire night treat. I'm going to cut some wedges. While I cut some wedges, should we go for a little recap?
Yeah, I'm glad you said that. I'd completely forgotten.
Here we go.
Look who's here. You've got
here
a lot to live up to now.
Try a bit of
that. Yes, I will, definitely.
Fiona,
try.
It is like a focaccia,
isn't
it?
It's a focaccia, yes.
Italiano. Veggie sausages in there as
Perfect.
Well.
Perfect. Chorizo as well. Tomato, sunblushed tomatoes, that kind of thing. Mm. But you imagine it, we're stood by the bonfire now, girls.
Ooh, that is nice.
The fireworks are going off. We're having a little munch, a meal in one.
It's English
Have a great
version.
Bonfire.
Got it, very good.
Thank you.
Yeah?
That's it. I'm sorry. So people always ask me to speak with my mouth full as well. It's so rude, and you're so classy, Nancy. I think she's enjoying it, though.
Oh,
and for today's recipe, you can log on to the website, itv.com/Lorraine. And I haven't said thank you, but thank you.
I get a kiss.
Enjoy your bonfire. Right?
And you. Cheers.
My dad used to get so cross with us because we used to do penny for the guy. And I remember one day he dragged us off the street. He said, I'm not having my children begging. But anyway, we'll be talking lots more to Nancy.